decided for my new PS3 that I was going to do my very own unboxing video. And I've never done one before, probably will never do one again, and I'll probably mess it up. But it's just for those of you who can see this, so my friends and family. And I figured you guys might find it hilarious. I don't know. Anyways, I went and bought my new PS3 at GameStop this afternoon. When I was checking out, the manager came by and threw a free game in. So, cool. I got the blue one, which wasn't supposed to come with the game. So apparently, since it's a GameStop exclusive, they decided to do a little sale and give away free games. So the game they gave me was Jackson Dexter Collection. I have very little interest in the game, but I'll probably look it up online, see if it might interest me, because it is apparently a platformer similar to Spyro and Crash Bandicoot, which I did enjoy. So I might keep it, and if not, I'll sell it on Amazon and use it to buy another game. So, get it out of the bag. Isn't this so pretty? I'm kind of glad I waited so long to buy a PlayStation 3, because I would have been really mad if they'd come out with this blue one after I bought one. So. I see. Just a box. Still a box. And they put paper on the box. I guess it's their way of saying, yes, this is new. Yeah, I could get a knife, but that'd be easy. But God gave one. Fingernails! So the first thing is what looks like a little USB cable of some description. I'm not sure. I think these are the component cables. But when I got my new DVD player, I got multiple HDMI cords, so I've already got one for the PlayStation 3. Okay. Then the pretty blue controller. Because of course the controller has to match, which I'm glad we thought about. So definitely a classic Sony PlayStation controller. I mean, I could go over there and grab my one from my PS2, and it looks very similar except for the color and the addition of the little port in the back, which makes me think that's what the cord is for charging the. I think it's a wireless controller. So I'm guessing it's for charging. And then they added this little extra button in the middle. Ooh, wonder what that's for. The power cable, very important. That's where we can find it. And I decided to go with the blue one, even though it's only a 250 gig hard drive. I really don't think I'm going to fill it up that fast. I'm not doing the PlayStation Network thing and all that, so. And if I do, a 1 terabyte drive that would fit in here is $60. So, screw it. I can upgrade later. Our guide to video game ratings. Very important. If you're one of those idiots who has a 10-year-old playing a mature rated game, maybe you should read this packet that comes in your system. And I think it's the owner's manual. Very small. Way smaller than the Wii's. The Wii's was like a 300 page book. Kind of thing. It was in like 10 languages though. So. There's the important part. Very carefully packed. So if you already have a PlayStation 3, you're not going to get the blue one. You can live vicariously through me now. That is a pretty color. I see some people on Games spot like comments area saying they thought it was an ugly color, but I think that's a very pretty color. I mean, I'm glad it's not like super light blue or anything. That's a nice dark color. It'll show all the dust very well. So let's see. I'm guessing that's where the cables go in for the controllers. I've never actually seen a PS3 in person besides the ones in store, so if I look like an idiot right now, I'm sorry. Okay, they take the game tray out. Smart. And there's the HDMI and the power, and if you're going to hardwire the LAN, I of course would be doing Wi-Fi. The only thing that really kind of bugs me with these is they always show them on the advertisements with the stand, and it does not come with a stand. But that's fine, I made space. One thing I did before I started shooting the video is I had to clean up my shelves under my TV and make room for Big Blue here. So here's the before picture of what that shelf looked like. And here's the after picture. So that's everything out of the box. Cool. So I guess now it's time to put it in place. And what the heck, you guys can watch. Give me a second while I change the camera. Okay, we're back. So before I even move the system over there, I'm gonna go ahead and do the HDMI cable because it requires me lifting my TV. And I prefer not to have such stuff in the way as possible. So. The joys of being short. I had a TV installed higher than I can reach. But I love it up here, so. Except, of course, when I need to try to look behind it, and then it's a pain. My honey's trying to jump off the shelf. Almost forgot. Fortunately, the thing they hook these on lets you do that. So I just have to find where the HDMI's go. Everybody say hi to Fusion! The actual place the plug went in, the like right general vicinity. I actually have it set up for this to have like four divided walls, but there's only one exit, and there's no way for me to do them because there's nothing on the back end to let me run through. So we'll just do that. So there's the cord, obviously way longer than it needs to be, but I don't care. Tuck it behind. Like I do all the other cords, they get tucked behind. Like so. We'll leave a little play for now to put the thing in. So, fortunately, one thing this shelf really lacks. Oh, wow. That was easy. I just very quickly opened the tray without even pretending to. Anyway, I don't have enough outlets here, so DVD takes up one, this takes up one, and the Wii is taking up one, and then all the PlayStations I have share one outlet. I just switch between them, so I'm never going to play two systems at once anyway. Yeah, that looks fine. Nice and slick. Get our twisty off. And figure out which one is our PlayStation cord. It's this one. So let's see. Nope, that's the DVD. This one? This one? I have no idea what I'm unplugging. So, okay, that one was a satellite. This one is something, I don't know what. This is my DVD player. We're going to move him over to the other side of the satellite so this makes more sense. Maybe I won't. There's just too many cords under here. Fine.
Which, sending out sparks.
Oh, okay, this one was it. I just didn't wait long enough for the light to go. So that's the PS2's cord, and that's the PS1 cord. So let's see if we can't get this over here, because I want to not stretch this too far. So this is the DVD cord. So I moved the DVD over with the satellite dish in here on the top. And now I can have the PlayStation here with the Wii. Switch the order. There's no point in the Wii being on top. The Wii gets very mad if it takes power over them. Kind of surprised at this point that these aren't 3-prong outlets, but I'm glad to because I don't have that many in this house. Put the cord up, and I'm going to carefully try not to open the door again. And turn this enough to see back here. Interesting that the tray will pop open without any power at all. I guess that's a good thing. I don't know. I guess it is good because if like your system breaks or something, you still get the email.